Good morning all. We'll take up next question that is simply supported beam with a single point load. We have to find the slope deflection for the beam. So the beam goes like this. There is a beam AB. Okay. It has got a single point load. Okay. It is here of 80 kilonewtons. The distances are given as 3 meters and 2 meters. Fine. So for this particular beam, we need to find the theta A, that is slope at A. We need to find theta B, that is slope at B. And we also have to find the delta, or you can call it delta like this, that is the deflection at point C. So this is your point C where the point load is acting, right? So these three things have to be found. This is the given beam structure. Now based on this, we know what is the elastic curve of the beam going to be. It is going to go like this. And to get the slopes, we need to draw the tangents, right? So when I draw the tangent, I'll be obtaining the thetas. We are aware of that. And also we know that the formula, that is if I want to find the slope, slope is given by the area of the bending moment diagram. And delta is given by the moment of that area of bending moment diagram, M by EI diagram, right? So before that, I have to draw the bending moment diagram for this. So looking into this, first we need the reaction values, that is RA and RB. How do we obtain the reactions? We have to use the equations of equilibrium. So summation f of y equal to 0 when I make use of, I have RA plus RB is equal to, what load is coming? Only one load, that is 80 kilonewton is coming downward. So RA plus RB equal to 80. Then I have to find one of the values of this. So I take summation MA equal to 0. That is, we take the moment of all the forces about point A. This has gone 80 into 3. It's clockwise direction, so it comes as plus. So 80 into 3 and RB into 5 goes with a minus sign. RB into 5 is equal to 0. From here, we get the value of RB. What is the value of RB, please? 80 into 3 divided by 5. How much? What is the value of RB? 48 kilo newtons. Once I know the value of RB, I can easily get RA substituting into this. So RA would be 80 minus 48. How much is RA? 32 kilonewtons. So now we know the values of RA, that is 32 kilonewton, and RB, which is 48 kilonewtons, right? We find the reactions because we need to draw the bending moment diagram. Else also, what is the formula to find, get the value of bending moment diagram when we have a single point load with different distances? What is the formula? There is one standard formula, no? We use that formula even while doing influence line diagrams. Okay. Tell me whether the beam is going to sag or hog. I've drawn the elastic curve actually. It is going to sag or hog? You can put it into the chat box. This beam sags or hogs? Quickly. Sag. So sagging is taken as positive. So bending moment diagram would be positive. So the bending moment diagram would come like this. Is it visible? What would be this value? What is this value of maximum bending moment? How do I calculate that? I can do RA into 3, or the formula for simply supported beam with a point load at different distances AB is WAB by L. Remember, we used in strength of materials also, we used in IID also. So I can directly use this formula also, that is 80 into 3 into 2 divided by total is 5, or RA into 3 also gives you the same value. How much is this value, please? How much is this value? WAB by L. Quickly.
96.
96. Correct. It is 96 by EI. I have given EI constant for the entire beam, say. Okay, 96 by EI you have to write. Now, if I want slope, I have to draw the tangent. Now, when we are doing this tangent thing for the simply supported beam, we will not just draw two tangents here. The drawing of tangent is in a different way. That is, you will have to draw this tangent such that it goes and intersects this point B. Okay, why I do that is, I will want to know this deflection here. I need to find that deflection. So we have to draw the tangent in such a pattern that it will go. If I'm drawing a tangent from here, it should go and intersect this line of action, like that. So this is your tangent drawn. I will call this ordinate, this height, say it is TBA, because B to A, so TBA I will call it. I will require this one also. We will do it at the later when we are substituting, we will take care of that. Okay, so this is the your diagram which will show the tangent and the various parameters, right? So once you get the bending moment at C, right, we will first find the deflection and then we'll go to slope. Deflection is this. Okay, so I have to first find the deflection. To find the deflection, what is the formula? Deflection is got by taking the moment of M by EI diagram. Am I right? I will be taking the moment of the diagram, matlab area into the perpendicular distance. Now these are two triangles, but I don't want to take them as two triangles. I want to consider this as whole one triangle. So when we have a case, we have not studied this prior. So if you have a situation where you have a triangle like this, okay, say this is distance A, this is distance B, and I want to find the total area of this triangle. So this is going to be base, and say this is your height. So what is the area of the triangle? Area is given by half base into height, right? After that, when I want the CG, how do I get the CG for this? Now we are used to usually dividing this into two right angle triangles, and once there are two right angle triangles, then 1/3 from the 90 degree we take as the CG. But I don't want this as two, I want it as one. So when we are doing this, the area will be same, half base into height. CG when we are doing, say I'm going from here and I'm going from this end. Okay, so when we are going from this here, that is left to right, it is L plus A divided by 3. A is what? This distance. Similarly, if I'm coming from that side, it is going to be L plus B divided by 3. This is the standard equation for the entire triangle CG. Okay, if I want to find the CG of this. So let us calculate here for our particular case. We know the values. A value is 3. B value is 2. Total L value is 5 meters. Okay. Total L value is 5 meters. This is known to us. So what we will do now, L plus A by 3 means, what is L? 5 plus A is 3 divided by 3. What is this value? Similarly, L plus B, 5 plus 2 divided by 3. What are these two values, please?
2.66,
correct. And this one?
2.33.
Yes, CG distance is, if I'm taking A, it is 2.66. If I'm taking B, it is going to be taken as 2.33. Okay, so it is left up to you which side you will be doing. So I'll keep this at handy only. So when we take the distances, we will take that into consideration. So come back to our general M by EI diagram. So now when I want to find the deflection, right? So deflection is what? This is the deflection. When I draw the tangent to this figure, this TBA is my deflection. I want to find this deflection. So if I want to find TBA, okay, it is nothing but moment of M by EI diagram, okay, between A and B, both extreme points. Why? Because the name itself is BA, AB, right? So I have to take between A and B. So let us start taking the moments. So first, for moment, I need the area. Half, base is 5, height is 96, half base into height, okay? 96 by EI, right? Into the perpendicular distance I have to take. Now, one we got 2.66 and another we are getting 2.33. We have to consider the one which is, now see, look at this triangle. Where would the CG lie? Towards this side, no? So I have to take this consideration. The CG that is coming from here, that is 2.33, has to be accounted. So into 2.33. Okay, half base into height into 2.33 is your answer. How much is this? Please check.
559.2.
I will take it as 560 by EI. Okay, this is nothing but TAB also, or TBA. Okay, keep it as TBA. It is a TBA value. Once you get this, okay, 560, correct? No, 560 by EI you have got. This value, yeah, is also called as TBA, from B to A. T means this distance. Now look into this figure. If I want to get this, is it possible or not? Can I find this distance? Can I find this distance? Look into the figure. So I'll show you. Consider that triangle. It is something like this. It's visible? Yeah. And this is your TBA. And this is the angle made by it, that is theta, that is the slope that we have to find. The total length of the beam is 5 meters. Agree? Now I'll say tan of theta is opposite upon adjacent. Opposite is TBA, adjacent side is 5 meters. So what is the value of TBA then? 5 into tan of theta. Correct, no? But I'll take tan of theta is equal to theta A. It is very negligible. So tan of theta would be nearly equal to theta A. So here I get theta A equal to TBA by 5. Or I can write TBA is nothing but pi goes to the right hand side. So what happens? Upon TBA. Okay. Here. TBA is 5 times of theta A. Correct. TBA is equal to 5 times of theta A. We found the value of TBA. Then I will be making use of this equation. Right. So once that is, this is done, we know that also TBA value is 560 divided by EI, correct? So equate these two. 5 times of theta A will be equal to 560 by EI. Or what is theta A? 560 divided by 5 into EI. Give me the value of theta A, please. What is the value of theta A? Quick.
One one two,
correct. 112 by EI. It is radians. Why? Because it is the angle, slope, theta. 112 point EI is the what? Slope at A. Right? Now if I want to find the slope at B, say. If I want to find also theta B, how do we go with theta B? There is one condition. Theta A minus theta B will be equal to area of M by EI diagram. Okay. So you know that theta is got by area of M by EI diagram. Deflection is got by what? Moment of the area. So I want the theta value rotation. So that is going to be area of M by EI diagram. And theta A minus theta B we will be substituting as 112. Right. So this becomes 112 by EI, which is equal to area of the M by EI diagram. Here, I have to take the area of this. So this minus theta B minus this. Area is how much? Half base into height is equal to 0. From here, get me the value of theta B, please. What is the value of theta B? Theta B will go here, this will remain here. So 120 minus half base into height. How much is this? theta b value. I will not proceed till you answer. How much is theta b? Anybody got? See, I will substitute here. Yeah. How much? 128?
Minus, ma'am.
Yes, minus 128, correct. Minus 128 radians by EI. This is the value of theta b. This theta a minus theta b occurs in simply supported beams. Clear? We have not done this theta a minus theta b in cantilever. I'm doing in simply supported beam. Minus 128, we got the slope at b, we got the slope at a also. Now what is remaining? Now remaining part is the deflection. Right? Here, deflection. How do we get the deflection? Now this is delta c, this is tba. So if I want delta c, see, I will write it here, delta c. If I want this, I can use the similar triangle rule and also get, right? So instead, what I can do is, we can call this as, this point is c, we'll call this as c, c double dash, c, c dash. Okay, this distance is called as c, c double dash. So delta c can be got as 3 times of theta a minus t c a. That is your this value. Okay, so if you've not understood this, see, I will show how to get TCA. Now TCA is here. This is TBA, this is TCA. So coming back to TCA, it is going to be nothing but moment of M by EI diagram, okay, between A and C. When I was doing for these two, I took the entire moment of the bending moment diagram, right? But now what we are doing, we want only here. So I will take the bending moment diagram only that is coming here. Okay. So what is that? Half base into height. Base is how much? This is 3 meters. This is 2 meters. Okay. So this is half base into height is 96 by EI. Half base into height into perpendicular is how much? This distance. Sorry. Should I take from here or should I take from here? I'm finding delta at this point, so CG distance is this, okay? So that is going to be 1/3 of 3, right? So this is your moment. How much is this? 1/3 of 3, this is gone. And 96 into 3 divided by 2, that makes it 144 by EI. Am I right?
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So you get, because we are doing deflection at this point, so we are taking bending moment of only this area, and I want here, so this CG will be considered, okay? This CG will be considered. So 144 by EI. And after that, I will draw this triangle here. Observe. I said this is TCA, correct? This is TCA. This is your theta A. I call this as C, C dash, say. This is 3 meters. I'm simply drawing this main triangle at this point. Okay. Now again, I can take tan of theta A equal to opposite by adjacent. That is TCA divided by 3. From here, tan of theta A is equal to theta A only. That is TCA by 3. Or what happens to TCA? It is 3 times of theta A. Right. So from this, I have written here 3 times of theta A minus TCA delta C. Okay, that is why I said we will first do this and then get back to this equation. So this is TCA value is 3 times of theta A. So get back, we found the value of TCA, 144 by EI. Now I can find delta C, which is going to be equal to 3 times of theta A minus TCA substitute. 3 times of theta A. What was the theta A value you got? 112 by EI. Minus TCA is 3 times of, again, sorry, TCA value we got, no, 144 point EI. Calculate this, please. It is 3 into 112 by EI minus 144 by EI.
192. Delta C. 192 by EI.
192 by AI. Okay, now this is the delta at this point. That is the deflection at this point. How do we get this deflection? So what we did first, I'll just revise. So when we started, we drew the bending moment diagram. After the bending moment diagram, deflection is equal to moment of the M by EI diagram. And using this condition, I first found TBA because this is the deflection at this point. So for to find the deflection at this junction, we took the moment of this entire triangle, right? Half base into height. And to take the CG of this such a triangle, I told you the formula. It is L plus A by 3 or L plus B by 3. Doing that, we got 2.33. We took the moment and we got a value. That value is your deflection value of 560, right? After that, using this triangle, deflected triangle, we got the value of theta A. That is, we apply regular trigonometry. Tan of theta is opposite by adjacent, TBA divided by 5. From there, I got theta A as TBA. Is it visible? Yeah. TBA divided by 5, right? And then we substituted TBA equal to 5 times of theta A and did the substitution. We got the value of theta A 112, right? Then we wanted theta B. While taking theta B, theta A minus theta B, we took the area, slope. No, this is. So when we are dealing with slope, it is going to be only the area. So we considered only the area, half base into height, that is 96, and we got theta B, that is 128 radians. And after this, we had to also find the deflection. Actual question was deflection at this point, right? So to get the deflection at this point, what we do, we take, consider the similar triangles or consider this triangle, find tan of theta A equal to CC dash divided by 3. Using that we get TCA equal to 3 times of theta A, and then put it into delta C. Delta C would be 3 times of theta A minus TCA, and we get the value of delta C, that is 192. Okay, so this is when we have a single point load. Now the same thing, you can get a question stating for a simply supported beam with a point load W spaced as A and B distances and whose length is L, find the theta A, theta B and delta at this point C. Okay, so you know the bending moment diagram is going to be like this now, and I know this value is W AB by L. Also, we know that if I'm taking the elastic curve like this, I draw a tangent. Wherever you have the least distance, we will take up to that. And this distance I have to find. This is the deflection. And using that, we find the deflection at this point. Okay. So first, we will find the value of this, height of this, using tan of theta. And then taking the moment of this entire diagram. So the same numerical, everywhere, instead of weight value or distances value as 3 and 5, what we did, you have to go on substituting with A and B. The same numerical now. Now this one, right? When I'm taking here area, right? TBA, area of the bending moment diagram. I write half. Base is what now? L. Height is what? Here I will write WAB by L. This is L, okay? Into this distance would be, you'll have to write it in words. That is L plus A by 3, no? We got this L plus A by 3 and L plus B by 3. So now you will get a bigger term parameter here when I calculate TBA. Then again, go put up that triangle. This is your total L. So tan of theta becomes TBA divided by L you do. And then theta A is equal to TBA divided by L. It will be in terms of L. So everywhere your values would be in terms of W or L, and EI will be there because that is the flexural rigidity. This type of question also might arrive. I wanted to tell is they can give you a question of that type also, where they will tell you, do it for a simply supported beam who is taking a point load of W like this. Okay, so be prepared for that, those kinds of questions also. Clear? Any doubt with this? Today's numerical, I will circulate the notes today. Just go through them, and if you have any doubts, please revert back. Okay.